Hello and welcome. It is Friday, and that means it's time for some more Darkest Dungeon fun. As you can see, we are in a plus 100% shards collected this week situation. So we will be heading toward the farmstead. And we've just got to get everybody in there. This stuff is pretty good. Got accuracy on the leper, all kinds of normal stuff that helps us out. Actually, before we get started, let me just pop this up there. Okay, now everything seems to be working. Let's get it started. Bring some extra food, because why not? No, I don't need that. I'll top those off. And you know what? Actually, I have enough cash. We can do this, and we can use it to get rid of buffs if we need to. I mean, I guess we have enough cash that I don't have to worry about... Hold on. There we go. I mean, it's expensive, but now we can use these things to our, you know, as much as we want, basically. I'll even pop that one up to full, because we just have so much cash. So, yeah, here we go. Let's do this.
The poor miller. Thrice a victim. The seasons took his livelihood. I took his land. And now, uncountable years later, the comet has taken his humanity. My only regret is that I did not live to see that shoddy mill smashed to pieces by the miraculous bounty I reaped from beyond the void.
Good times. Let's do it. This time, let's try not to screw it up. Take it nice and slow.
Masterfully executed.
Okay, he's hiding. I guess he's gonna screw with our formation next turn, which is like the worst. A little damage there, not too bad.
Confidence surges as the enemy crumbles.
Seeds of madness.
Be gone, fiend.
I mean, the horse is gonna move and mess with our formation, right? Trample, the usual. Messing with our
their cursed champion falls.
See, that was a bad move. You see what I did there? But it looks like it's gonna work out anyway. I gotta be really careful taking out the horses to take out the one in the front. I mean, I guess. Almost. Yeah, we'll just take care of it. We don't need the hit points, so we don't need to leave the corpse up. any stress, so we just, you know, waste turns until the force field is vulnerable. Okay, this isn't too bad. Get him in front. Move him up. Another freaking horse. This is ridiculous. Okay, we can't use that. Because that'll keep our... I mean, we can, I guess, right? Because he has an attack that can come in from behind. So it's not too bad. Don't stun.
A victory. Perhaps the turning point.
Why can't... Oh, because he's hidden. That's garbage.
Momentary abatement.
We got two seeds of madness. We gotta take those out first.
Another one falls. Another abomination cleansed from our lands.
It's interesting. Can we stun him? No. They're really... They're messing with me. They are messing with me.
Monstrous size has no intrinsic merit, unless inordinate exsanguination be considered a virtue.
Seems reasonable to... Inordinate exsanguination might be a virtue. Give us some bleed. Oh yeah. Okay, give us some stun.
A decisive pummeling.
Didn't work. It's like a 45% chance for us. Here's paw the ground again. We've seen that before, that gives him a riposte. Here comes Trample. It's gonna mess with our formation again, as usual. This time didn't bring the Vestal up front, so that's better.
The bigger the beast. The greater the glory.
That's not bad. Ooh, a mark. Come on.
Vigor is restored. Precision and power.
That should kill him, yes. Wow, really? 4-for-3 isn't as bad as 4-for-5, though.
the slow death. Unforeseen. Unforgiving. A momentary abatement. Resupply and recover, but be quick.
I guess we can't run the timeout. One round is not that big of a deal. We'll heal him, because he's at the most damage. And we press on. I wish one of our characters had a move that would just, like, automatically trigger at the beginning of each turn. No. Desjardins, you're supposed to be dodging that stuff. 8 damage per round. Holy cow. He's going down. He's in trouble. Okay, we critted there, which is good, but he's still losing a lot of hit points at the beginning of the next turn. Jeez. I mean, we are getting walloped here.
Continue the onslaught. Destroy them all.
That's the right move for that. We're gonna bandage. Finally.
Executed with impunity. Advantage. Give them no quarter. Great is the weapon that cuts on its own.
Of course. More horses.
Quakes.
Here it comes. Dodge it. Nope, no luck.
The flesh is knit. Size alone does not dissuade the sharpened blade.
Take care of him. 3 seeds of madness. Good gravy. position in a minute. Come on. Two down. Now our final move. As long as they don't explode, we're good. We just have to make sure they don't explode. That's at least a small bonus. For a whip, it does so much damage. Like, supposedly it's a whip hitting a very well-armored person. To do damage. Come on. It's alright, she can take it. Four for five, jeez. No, not that. That. Marcy!
Of refuge, if only for a fleeting moment.
Plentiful bounty. Okay, works for me. We press on. Okay. Extra bloodsteel trance
folds in on itself.
Extra trance stress. They get more blood skill chance and more dodge. We've had this before. That dodge is a real killer for us. Yeah, like that. And that.
Strike.
No blood though. Oh, they're doing it again. Ooh, and then again. How about that? No, didn't push him. Sorry. Surprising that the damage. Oh no, it's the Uka Savage.
Impressive.
Get some light into this team. Oof. She's getting close. Items on other party members. Like, even if it took up a turn? The Octocestus misses. Oh, Tile Slam! Okay. That's just straight up damage, and possibly a stun. The incantation that time. Ooh, man. Critical, come on. One hit point.
Slowly. Okay.
Bleed kills him.
This is how a life is taken.
Whew. to do. Especially since it reduces stress on like subsequent attacks. Okay, he's done next turn. Okay, this isn't too bad. Don't you? No, it's just the buff. Didn't heal him. He's still down.
Compassion is a rarity in the fevered pitch of battle. Closer look, perhaps. If only treasure could staunch the flow of otherworldly corruption. Anchored on solid ground.
All right, here we go, back to normal. Minor effect. Not too bad. I swear to God, if these things keep dodging! It does get a little ridiculous sometimes. Come on. It's alright, we can take it. I think she can handle it. It's only a total of 12 damage. She's already healed 4. One down to start. Yeah, if they just use ceaseless labor, it's not so bad. She just got out of blight. Here comes Trample. This could be bad. Yeah. is in fact why it's bad. That thing's gonna explode. There's nothing we can do about it. Okay, it didn't do that much damage.
The horror.
Maybe the damage depends on how many hit points are left in it? Question mark? It's possible. And the horse does the stupid thing again.
Behind, battle ahead. But for a moment, peace.
Okay.
A spark without kindling is a goal without hope.
Anything that lasts multiple battles, we want. Something we should do is we should change what their abilities are for the camp abilities, because we could definitely do better than this, since we don't need to worry about... I've never thought about messing with that. Okay, yeah, that's a really good idea. No other buffs. Here we go. Next up. Please.
An encounter from the past, or perhaps the future.
Okay, they're vulnerable to bleed.
Waits for the slightest lapse in concentration.
kills him first so he can't psychokinesis on us.
A brilliant confluence of skill and purpose.
That's not too bad. That is excellent. That thing's going down. It's not even going to leave a corpse that another slime can pick up. If it's on set. Oh boy. Yes. That's the perfect timing. That's just what we want. I mean, sure, I guess. If it's not... God dang it. Totally whiffs. Stun can buy us some time. There we go. Let him die next turn naturally. Turns of healing for that to work out.
Soothed. Sedated.
A couple of seeds of madness, that could be for him. HP significantly. It brings her down to 36. Oh, I hope this works. You gotta be kidding me.
Of war can be healed.
but never hidden.
An extra damage versus unholy never seems to do that much. Shame. The stress is pretty high.
From the comet's maddening light. For now.
Alright, this is the Miller fight, if I'm not mistaken. What is that? 4 damage per 1 round. Not gonna worry about it. Here we go!
The poor fool still stands, battered and broken as his precious mill.
Very strange move on his part. And we can't bleed him now that I think about it. We should probably do. I think I have an idea.
A dizzying blow to body and brain.
Good lord. I have an idea though. Come on, if I can pull it off, we're gonna try this.
Soothed. Sedated.
Is this Dirk stab, right? Come on.
Eradicated.
But here's the trick. When he Dirk stabs, because of the arrangement of their speed, they can just swap back and forth every turn if I feel like it. This might work if we can keep the stress levels down.
annihilated.
Works for me.
Dazed. Reeling. About to break.
Again? He can just do it twice.
The very precipice of oblivion.
It's a little ridiculous.
Destroyed.
Would you quit it? 27. 19. He's got one hit point. No! No! He's guarded! Son of a gun!
Oh god!
Oh, come on.
Grievous injury. Palpable fear.
He's back. Thank you. Jeez.
Injury and despondence set the stage for heroism.
Now we're talking.
Or cowardice.
Bye, guys.
Instruments pause, but the symphony will soon continue.
Oh, stress reduction. Boop. Okay, not bad. Let's fix our formation. That's why I brought the extra food along. Let's fix that. Here we go. Splendorous. Okay, this is a good one.
An encounter from the past, or perhaps the future.
Now the bone bearer is a... trouble because he's going to revive people who are dead. Also, he gives everybody a 25% bonus to damage, which is kind of ridiculous. There's another 20% damage. Somebody get that spear from him! Okay. Can we kill the Lancer? Yes. He's gonna wake him up, but at least he loses the... Goodness, are you kidding me? None of these guys can be bled. Building up. That's very interesting. That did ridiculous damage, but... One down. Yeah, the meter raises. That's actually very interesting. So we can actually use the Bone Bearer as like a... The Bone Bearer is actually really good for us here. applicant's seeds of madness. Okay, cool. Interesting. That's a slightly different take on that battle, you know?
The wounds of war can be healed.
Because if this were a regular battle of ruins, we would have to take out that guy first. Or we'd have to break the corpse in before he gets a chance to wake him up. This guy is just stealth forever. Yeah, we're gonna push through this without killing a single guy. It's bizarre.
How quickly the tide turns.
20 stress, too. That's ridiculous.
Is a rarity in the fevered pitch of battle.
Yeah, that's all we had to do. There it is. Get us out.
Corrupted curiosity. Begging for examination.
Here we go. Alright. Party order is good. Everybody's healed.
Rejoice Proceed. At the familiar sight of mud, rain, and ruin.
I'll take it, you know, it's not too bad. Get some stun there. Feels like they have so many turns. Two down.
Soothed. Sedated.
Stun to save us some time. They didn't turn that one into a seize. Okay. Probably that's not the best move. I should have done the other one that just hits the single guy. It's probably okay. He's gonna take a break? Of course he is. Well, that bumps his speed way up, though. So he'll get a turn, like, probably first. No, maybe not. Wow! Wow! Yes!
Sheltered corner of reality.
Just for the heck of it. There we go. Good enough.
Listening shard of memory.
Can we take this one? I think we can. Oh, his accuracy buff ran out. Stuns. We want stuns. He's done. Two seeds are done. There's some lovely vomit. She has scurvy. Two diseases. Skyver. Ooh, look at that stress. Huh.
momentary abatement.
Limits.
It's impossible. Nope. It's like a 40% chance or something. It's alright. We're fast enough. Wow. Beautiful hit. There's our friend. Woo! Alright.
A cosmic dreamscape. A waking nightmare.
Last one.
Gathered close in tenuous firelight and uneasy companionship.
Seeker?
Reality regained.
A fracture? No. This isn't the Seeker, this is something else. Oh, I remember this fight. This fight wasn't so bad. Stunned. managed to bleed one, which is a little surprising. Killed one, critted another. Now it'll grow, probably. Yeah, they get full hit points whenever they expand. It's a little irritating. Size number three, though, they don't have any more expansion to do, so.
Mortality clarified in a single strike.
It's not too bad. Okay, then they pop. Okay, interesting. This fight before with a team just like this, I thought. Yeah, that's not so bad. Yeah, he really can't be bled. She can stun him, but... Dang it. He just gets so many turns. I healing type. We need to get rid of it. Four turns. Every turn. Stun though sucks. It's a blue one.
Compassion,
it just gets so many turns
in the fevered pitch of battle.
Really? There's a red one. That's not too bad either. Unstable ones. We should keep our hit points up. No stuns. Okay, now that one's gonna defend. We just can't do enough damage. Ridiculous. It pierces guard. Okay, mostly dodged. It's not too bad. Two down. That one's gonna pop. Focus all you want. This strategy is where we're going. At least if he's in the third slot. If he's in the fourth slot, we just can't reach him. Oh, it does heal him. Great. Wonderful.
The wounds of war can be healed, but never hidden.
Please stop. Thank you. It's only got 30 hit points left, or 32 technically. Crit. It's gonna Eternal Blossom. Oh, oh, he changed! Okay, now I remember. He becomes the sleeper after you damage him enough. Now he has 220 hit points. Thanks, game. He really can't be bled. He destroyed us last time. Like, it was sad. Yeah. He awakens. He stirs. It's like it's designed to end the mission.
Facing the abyss.
Those are his only two attacks. No, don't. Oh, it hurts so much. We need a virtue or something. We're in trouble. Nice critical. Come on, make it happen. Just pick everybody up off of Death's Door. He stirs again. Death's Door.
From becoming unwound.
It's the best. It's the best. Gonna be freaking out in the next turn or so. 80 hit points. 70 hit points. Okay. 36 hit points. He awakens again. Boop. I wish we'd dodge that stuff.
And
it's so bad.
The true test. Fast or expire.
We're maxing out stress. Someone virtue, please. Oh, great. Wonderful.
Madness.
I don't know if that's not a good thing.
Sublimity.
Ignore stealth.
The intelligence.
Okay.
Oh, so it has been said.
Now she's refracted. Ignore stealth. That's so. I don't know. Maybe it's not so bad. Don't you? What? Three hit points. We're so freaking close. Okay. 14. One more good hit will do it. If we can just get that hit off.
As life ebbs,
Death's Door, Death's Door, Death's Door, Death's Door.
Terrible vistas of emptiness reveal themselves.
Freaking out. Abusive. Okay, he didn't refract.
Frustration and fury. More destructive than 100.
4 hit points. Come on! No! What was even the death blow? No, she passed! Oh god, this is horrible. Okay, he's done. We got him. We beat the sleeper.
Or perhaps.
Woo!
Reborn.
Holy cow. We're done, right? Does he? I guess we still have to make our moves? But he's done, right? We're done. Oh, yeah.
A place of refuge. If only for a fleeting moment.
Yeah. Cool. Well, we beat it. We got a memory. Let's retreat. We get 24k in regular gold too. 70 kills. It's actually not our best. And she got a third disease. Whatever.
The plume and the pistol. A fitting end to my folly. And a curse upon us all.
I have one memory. I have to do that 10 times in order to get the mill? You gotta be freaking kidding me, man. put those back on him. Oh, and they're still... It didn't count for a week. That's always interesting. Alright, fine. Start with bad humors. Do some treatment. And that'll do it. Whew, well, that was fun! My first time beating the Seeker. By the skin of my teeth, too. Oh, man, that was rough. He, like, had us, like, one more turn and we would have been done for. But that strategy of doing the Jester's Stab followed by the Crusader's Holy Lance, that worked out pretty well. I hadn't figured that one out before, but now I know. So... we'll call this here for tonight. Next week we'll get back to the Countess quest. And yeah, let's see, what else have we got going on? We've got Monday, we've got Signalis, which is kind of a fun science fiction survival horror game. We've got Legend of Grimrock on Wednesday, which we might be getting close to the end of, but it's been a lot of fun with some really good puzzles to play around with. And then we've also got, over on YouTube, we've got Labyrinth of Toho and Final Fantasy X, no commentary. So, if any of that sounds good, feel free to take a look. Otherwise, I'll just say thanks for watching, thanks for listening, and hope to see you later.